The shopping mall, an American icon rarely acknowledged for its landmark status. It's easy to forget that less than 60 years ago, shopping was a drastically different experience.
It's a happy-go-spending world, reflected in the windows of the suburban shopping centers where they go to buy.
With the suburban boom of the 1950s, consumers were looking to avoid trips downtown to individual stores where parking was becoming difficult. So Austrian-born architect Victor Gruen designed a building to solve those problems. He set his first design here, in Edina, Minnesota, a suburb of Minneapolis, and called it Southdale. Today, Southdale may look like many other malls in America, but it is the first indoor mall ever built, and that makes it significant.
So this court is part of the original court, and there were two department stores.
Tom Fisher is a professor of architecture and dean of the College of Design at the University of Minnesota. He spent plenty of time studying Gruen's original plans for Southdale.
So Gruen's idea of putting competing mall department stores on the either end of the mall would be that it would attract more people. And also, as people went back and forth between the two department stores, it would generate more traffic to the smaller stores in between.
The concept of the enclosed mall with competing department stores, ample parking, climate control, and multiple levels of shopping was a revolutionary idea when Southdale opened in 1956.
I mean, what were people used to at that time? Why was this such, you know, just a brilliant idea on his part?
Well, Victor Gruen felt that the shopping centers at the time, which he called extroverted, were typically a parking lot and stores facing the parking lot with big garish signs. And he thought that they were ugly and they weren't a very good shopping experience. So he envisioned the mall as what he called the introvert type. And so basically he took the stores that used to face out to the parking lot and faced them into an enclosed mall. And part of his idea was to control the signage and the aesthetics so that it was all a modern minimalist aesthetic. His hope was to get people out of their cars and interacting in a pedestrian environment more akin to what he experienced in Vienna. So he wanted to actually create a bit of urbanity in the suburbs in the mall.
Gruen hoped to bring some European charm to his vision of the shopping mall. He incorporated original art, like this Harry Bertoia sculpture. The mall originally had an aviary and hosted fashion shows when it first opened. The idea of an open-air cafe might not seem unusual in Europe, but inside a U.S. mall, it was certainly different.
And again, many of these things we now so take for granted because Southdale was really an archetype. It was really the model that then was replicated hundreds and hundreds of times everywhere, so much so that we just assume that, well, this is just what a mall is. But of course, it took somebody like Victor Gruen to imagine it and to do it the first time.
The opening of Southdale was covered by the likes of the New York Times and Life magazine. But as original mall manager Marty Rudd recalls, not everyone was a fan of Gruen's design.
Frank Lloyd Wright, of course, had to come. And you can imagine how excited he was about this and how complimentary he was. No compliments at all.
With 1,511 indoor shopping malls in operation today, the impact of Gruen's design is clear. In fact, there was talk of designating Southdale as a historical landmark, but because the mall has been updated over time, very little of the original building remains.
The mall isn't the physical structure. The mall is it's a social and economic idea. And so the fact that it changes over time, I think is fine. And I actually think Gruen would be fine with that too.
I'm Tracy Wholf, reporting for the NewHour.